think this is around about the time where they would tell you to listen to this track, bitch.
I don't give a fuck, they don't like me.
Concerned about my real life, and that's alright. But who are you? Just another nigga with a strap. It don't take rocket science to shoot. You don't know shit about getting drinks at your price, still work true for true. You don't know shit about on your blood, cause you paid your bills with all that loot. How about your baby about to be born and he don't got pampers, wipes, or food? How about your mama fucking your best friend and y'all both just finished school? But it's okay, she thinks it's cool. You're in her way, it's time you move. And you just paid all her damn bills, so you feel like a fool. So what do you suggest I do? You think you know, you got no clue. So please don't tell me what you think I ain't been through.
I don't give a fuck, they don't like me.
They don't like me.
I say I don't give a fuck,
they don't like me.
They don't like me.
Oh no, I don't give a fuck,
they don't like me.
Sorry,
I don't give a fuck,
they don't like me.
Welcome, 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 welcome to AJ's Day. Yes! Well, I know you guys didn't hear me last week. I was totally busy. Everybody know that I am walking in May. So, everybody kept on saying, when you become a senior, you're about to graduate. It's going to be more easy. It is not easy. It has gotten so hard. And I'm doing homework. As soon as I finish recording here, I have to do problem sets and I have to do a report. So it's not that easy leaving. They just look like they're making it harder and harder. I'm still keeping my A's up and everything. Hearing back from colleges, some that I want to hear from and some that I didn't want to hear. Some refused me and some didn't. So whatever, the college that I really want to go to is Texas Southern University, Thurgood Marshall Law School, and I haven't heard back from them yet. So I keep my fingers crossed. I really want to go there, but I still have more application to fill out. So yeah, I've been pretty busy. It's not that easy. So. Let's talk about the things that we've been hearing. The threats that come from the so-called president. And you guys who voted for him. Oh, now the percentage of Trump relationship or people caring about Trump or the rating of Trump is 37%. And I'm surprised he have it that high. That's pretty high. I thought it would be, I say 5%. But he have 37%. I don't even know where to start at. I'll just start on Trumpcare. Trumpcare. Guys, you voted. Y'all wanted this ACA to go so bad. And the reason why you wanted it to go so bad, because first of all, the ones who so uneducated didn't know that Obamacare was ACA. That's the first thing. And they loved the ACA. They didn't like Obamacare. And they failed to realize that Obamacare was ACA. It's ACA. They just didn't like the name because it was a black name. And I'll put it in your face and I'll say it in your face. I don't care. Simple as that. I know the reason why. Because you can't even say this man still doesn't have a policy. He said, he lied to you so many times. So many times. I'm going to bring it up what I wrote. I'm going to read everything what I wrote. And I want you guys to think about it. And we're going to get in depth about Obamacare, because I'm typing this in because I want you guys I want you guys to think about this. I wrote this, and this is what I wrote, because a whole lot. And you guys just sat up there and defended him. Some people still defending him, and they're hurting. Some people who's not going to be affected is defending him because of the racism that they have within. Well, we're going to see this. He called Hillary Clinton a crook. You bought it. Then he paid $25 million to settle a fraud lawsuit for that school. He said he would release his taxes tax return. Eventually, you bought that. He hasn't. He said he would never. He said he would divest himself for his financial empire to avoid any conflicts of interest. You bought that. He is still heavily involved in his businesses. Manipulations. He said he was gonna put, he said Clinton was in the pocket of Goldman Sachs and would do whatever they say. And would do everything what Goldman Sachs says. You bought that. He then proceeded to put half a dozen Goldman Sachs executives in positions of power in his administration. He said he'll surround himself with all the best and smartest people. You bought it. He nominated Mike Pence, who killed Indiana, as a vice president. He also brought in Steve Bannon, who's well known as a white nationalist. He put Dr. Ben Carson in control, the leader of HUD. And he knows nothing about HUD. He put Rex Tillerson as the Secretary of State. And he is in cahoots with Russia. He said he'll be his own man. Behold to no one. You bought that. He then appointed Bessie DeVos as Secretary of Education, whose only qualification were to mass amount of cash she donated to his campaign. He said he would drain the swamp of Washington inside. You bought that. You bought it. Then he admitted that was just a corny slogan. He said he knew more about strategy and terrorism than the general. You bought that. He promptly gave the green light to disaster raids in Yemen, even though all his generals said it would be a terrible idea. This riot would result in the death of a Navy SEAL. Remember that lady who was standing up there? Navy SEAL. For 8 years, have an 8-year-old daughter and numerous civilians. The actual target of the raid escaped and no useful intel was gained. Do you hear me? They're keeping that hush hush though. That's the only thing that bitch did. Y'all know I don't cuss. I use profanity. You bought it. He said Hillary Clinton couldn't be counted on in the times of this crisis. You bought it. He didn't even bother overseeing that raid in Yemen. And repeat it again. The generals told him not to do it. Not to do it. But what did he do? He got on Twitter and started tweeting hateful tweets. He doesn't even attend daily meetings that presidents supposed to attend. He called CNN, the Washington Post, and New York Times fake news and said they were his enemies. You bought it. He now gets on his information from Barber, Gateway, and InfoWars. And he wouldn't have to get all that information if he takes daily meetings. You bought it. He called Barack Obama the vacation in chief. Accused him of playing more rounds of golf than Tiger Woods. He promised to never be the kind of president who took crushing vacations on taxpayer dime. Not when there was so much important work to be done. You bought it. He took his first vacation after 11 days in office on taxpayers' dime and went golfing. And that was just his first month. That was just his first month, people. That was just his first month. You bought it. Now you want people to feel sorry for you. This man takes a vacation every Saturday on what? Taxpayers' dime. Every weekend he goes to Florida on taxpayers' dime. He said that he wasn't going to do that. Well, how y'all was going to stop him? You can't stop him now. He's president. We knew that. We knew he was lying. We knew that he was lying. But you want to live up in the racism that you are because he didn't have policies. You want to live that. So, I'm going to look this up. On taxpayer money versus President Obama in the 8 years. 8 years. And mind you guys, so you never thought of this too. We have to also cover him in the White House and his whole family, kids, and his wife that stays to Trump Tower that she will not stay in the White House. But, oh, she's so classy. I see so many car cases on the news media. Oh yeah, she's so classy. They are the best thing. We are so glad that they got rid of those 8 people. These unclassy people, uneducated. These people have more education than they can ever have. And you guys who have to downgrade President Obama and his family. His damn kids had more education than you did. But the only reason why you're like that is because of the racism that's within. And the first thing you say, I'm not racist. I have a black friend. Well, why your friend have to be black? Why don't you just say you have a friend? You have friends. See, you're unconscious racist. And some of you all know you're racist, but don't want to admit it. Some of you are coming out and admit it. Because I'm going to get on this domestic terrorism that y'all talking about, the Muslim, is domestic terrorism in the United States. And the only time things will happen is because of a Caucasian male. But you talk about people of color, because most Muslims are people of color. They don't want your religion that you put on people. You did it with the Native Americans. You try to take away from us. We are the only race that you really try. Because Native American resisted. We're the only race that you want us to bow down to you. And we are not doing it. You ask yourself why. You ask. Let's compare. By comparison, Barack Obama travel expenses averaged just $12.1 million during each year of his presidency. So that's 8 years. That's 8 years of his presidency. Round it off, 13. Get up to 24. One, four, carry that, eight, ten. That's about $104 million. Well, let's see. We'll turn it out. President Obama, 8 year travel bill came to $97 million. This is what Donald Trump was trying to tell people, that it actually came up to 104. I'm going to give it that. Okay? Let's compare. So y'all got, you have the comparison of President Obama a year. $12.1 million. Donald Trump in 1 month. I'm giving you 1 month, babies. 1 month. Now I'm going to go back. Let y'all know how much it costs for President Obama. $12.1 million a year. Do y'all hear me? A year. And he stayed there for 8 years. A year. Do you hear me? I want y'all to hear me. Come on now. I want y'all to hear me. And matter of fact, I'm going to open up my lines because I usually don't open up my lines. 314-741-9851. If you get disrespectful, you either get hung up on after I tell you off. But you can call me. 314-741-9851. I'll open up my lines. Now, $12.1 million a year with President Obama. Do you hear me? I repeated that. Y'all hear me? A year. I didn't say a month. I said a year. $12.1 million a year. 1 month, Donald Trump has spent $10.0 million. Look it up. Look it up. I did it. Look it up. It's less than $2.1 million of President Obama in that year. This is $10.0 million a month. Do y'all hear me, people? A month. M-O-N-T-H. A month. A month. Not months. A month. That's why that man was going to file bankruptcy if he wasn't going to win the presidential election. He was born with a silver spoon in his goddamn mouth. He didn't. That's why he was going bankrupt. He wanted to live above his means. He's not a billionaire. That's why he will not show his taxes. A month, people. $10.0 million. A month. Do I get some side effects on this or what? Wake the fuck up. You bought it. And now you want us to kumbaya. You want us to, ooh, yeah, they voted for him because of racism. And now you want African Americans to come together with you and hold hands. But not too long ago, you want to make America white again. Because when the last time America was great? to, I guess, to your eyes, when we were slaves, when our ancestor was slaves, it was great. That's interesting. That's real interesting. Because America never was great. You guys was killing and raping Native Americans. You guys was killing, raping African Americans, Africans. But it was so-called great. I guess if you can stick your penis in anything you want to stick your penis in, I guess it would be great, huh? Your president you voted in is he's going to bankrupt this country. He tweeted, President Barack Obama vacation is costing taxpayers millions of dollars. Unbelievable. He tweeted that January the 5th, 2012. He called on the Bertha movement. He never apologized to that because they got his birth certificate and found out that this man is American after all. Then he also called it on the Central Five when he wanted the Central Five to be killed. Nobody not bringing that shit up. And then he wanted to do a photo op with the HBC presidents. Hey, President Womack, yes, HBCU. HHSSHSSU, Harris Stowell, I 10. I love you, but that was full of, I wish you didn't do that. I know you were trying to do something for Harris Stowell. I know for a fact you have, was. You have been the best president for Harris Stowell. I thank you for the best 2 years that I was there that when you came in. But that was a photo op. Like he would say, I'm doing something for the HBCUs and African American. You're not doing shit. You cut. You lied to them. And I knew he was going to do it in the first place. He's a compulsive-ass liar. Compulsive-ass liar. He don't know if the truth hit him in his face. But you guys voted for him. Why? And I'm going to continue to say it. Because you're racist. If nobody don't serve your God, what God that it is, you're supposed to be Christian. You force that on almost everybody who's do not look like you. It's amazing. But you resent the British when the British was forcing their livelihoods on you. Spending $10 million a month. $10 million a month. Just imagine. So let's add this up. $10 million, 12 times 12. 10 times 12, 0, 2, 0. 1. That's $120. That's $120 million a year. So he's supposed to be enough for 4 years, people. He's supposed to be enough. That's $480 million. That's almost $500 million. And he's cutting from federal programming. Well, hell, we need to cut his ass and stop cutting his vacations. Stop getting straight up and saying, listen, we're not going to cover your family. If your wife don't want to stay in the White House, then we're not going to cover that. Let her ass be covered by your ass. You pay for it. Not by the taxpayers, by you. Your money. You're supposed to be such a billionaire. Y'all don't get it. Y'all voted for a person who didn't have a fucking policy. You voted for a person who was preaching hatred. And then as soon as he get in there, he said, oh, let me tell you this. I am going to bring the country back. The country was already divided because you guys who have pale skin think you better than us and we're inferior to you. We're already divided. We already had hatred. We have cops killing African American left and right and have not served one day yet. We can see the fine example when the cops set up there and shot Walter Scott in the back and lied on stand, and they have a video showing that this cop lied. And you still won't convict him. So the country was already divided. But somehow, he trying to bring the country back. You made it more divided. Except the Yahoos now, they want to come in the crowd now and say, yeah, I voted for Trump, but I regret it. Let's kumbaya. No, you voted for Trump because of hatred. So don't kumbaya with me. I am not my ancestors. So be gone. My ancestors said, let's pray. Yes, let's pray. You change your mind. Yes. And you did it over and over. And you thought you could keep on saying, I'm sorry, I'm sorry, I'm sorry. No. You cannot keep on saying, I'm sorry, I'm sorry, I'm sorry, and think somebody just going to keep on forgiving you and let's pray. No, I do not want to kumbaya with you. I will not be bamboozled and hoodwinked. Great Mark and Lorette said that. You sit up here and continue to think it's okay. And you want somebody to feel sorry for you and stuff. Nobody's not going to feel sorry for you. No. You want us to all come together. Yes, let's come together. We are sorry. We don't mean to do the things that we did. We didn't mean to just peek that. We didn't mean to get that. Well, I just want to say I'm so sorry. Stop crying. Stop crying. Well, let me do it again. I'm not gonna work with you. I'm gonna let you cry. I'm gonna let you suffer. Because not only they're gonna affect the Trumpcare, gonna only affect the Medicaid, the Medicare, the people like myself. I thought it was going to affect me. It's going to affect us, the people who work. And now that ACA look good. Couldn't believe that Obamacare look good. Now that black man put that in there, did he not? He put that in there. Y'all couldn't believe it. That black man. Woo! How dare him come up with something like that so good that y'all don't even know. Now y'all crying. No, don't take ATA. Wait, what that baby was doing? No, 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 don't take ACA. Oh, no, don't take ACA. Don't take Obamacare. I know ACA is Obamacare now. I know it. I know I'm being annoying. You know why I'm being annoying on purpose? Because you assholes sat up there and actually voted for a crooked ass guy that care nothing about it. He is in Congress right now threatening people if they do not pass it. And because he will not get his way like a child that he is, he say, if it don't pass, I'm not worried about it. It's going to stay there. ACA going to stay there. I'm not worried about it. Nah, 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 nah. I'm not worried about it. That's exactly how he's acting. He said it. If it does not pass, knowing that it'll hurt the same people, you guys who voted for him, it's going to hurt mainly the poor people, Caucasian. Y'all finally realize that it's not the African Americans who's actually on welfare. It's you that I've been telling you long time ago. 96% of you guys are on welfare. And you finally realize that is going to affect you. Congratulations. Give him a clap. Congratulations. Listen to that bullshit that he was feeding you. And you was eating it. Because you have hatred. And I always tell people, think about this. I always tell my people, you think about what happened to the kids who watched their mother and father hang our ancestors on the tree. Lo and behold, they came out when Trump was running and saying he's going to make America great again. We are not dumb. I don't know where you get this idea that we are dumb and we know nothing what you're saying. We know what those little quotes are. We know what you're saying. We're not dumb. This never was your country anyway. This Native Americans. And if you're talking about sending us back, say go back to your country, you first. Hell, our ancestors built this country and still building it. You didn't do nothing, not even contribute to it. You can sit up there and believe the hype all day long. Most of these patents are made by African Americans when they were stolen because they were slaves at that particular time. Hell, you wouldn't even have a polo virus if it wasn't for Henrietta Lacks. They let that African American woman suffer, never contribute to their family. Still to this day, they say, well, we're not going to give you no money, but we'll let you know that we're recognizing that. They think, African-Americans, y'all need to stop it. Stop letting these white Caucasians, these pale-faced people do whatever they want to do. And I'm going to always say, it's not all you pale-faced, but it's the most of you. The most of you are the ones who's feel threatened when you don't have an education and won't get none because you have that pale face, you think you should get a job right away. Without an education. Let's go into the domestic violence, the domestic terrorists. That everybody keep on talking about Muslims. That you continue to talk about Muslims. And Muslims are not the problem. It's the Caucasian male. How many Caucasian males that have did domestic violence? Let me look that up. Because I'm going to talk about this James Jackson. He's a Caucasian who stabbed a 66-year-old African-American man. And get this, the reason why he said he's targeting all African-American men is because they have having romantic relationships with Caucasian women. That he failed to realize Caucasian women from centuries ago have always been attracted to African-American men. Especially the ones who have money. But he attacked the 60, and he went after this is crazy. Y'all are such cowards, you Caucasian males. Y'all will sit up there and attack the weakest one. Won't go and try to attack somebody who's stronger than you or who's younger. You go and got the 66-year-old. Then, not only that, this man is still living. He walked into the police station with the sword that he killed this man with. Can you believe that? Now, if a black man would have walked in there, he would have been done. Done. Do you hear me? He would have been done. He would have been dead. Mm-hmm. Would have been dead. I want to compare. You know, I love comparing. White domestic supremacist domestic terrorists versus Islam terrorists. Let's go ahead and see this. Let's try to get this computer up so we can go. But I do want to play a video of him. He walked straight into police station and said, "I killed the African American men because of they're being attracted to they're getting Caucasian women." Isn't that crazy? Just took somebody's life because of that. Interesting. African American man would have, I swear, any person of color would have walked up in there. They would have killed them. The video is coming up right now.
The subject, as well as a preliminary review of video, it reveals that the attack on Timothy Kaufman was clearly racially motivated.
But I want to get the whole interview, so I am going to get it up. His name again is James Harris Jackson. James Harris Jackson in New York went up to a 66-year-old man, and I am going to find his name. This 66-year-old man, and killed him with a sword, stabbed him to death. This is domestic terrorism, but the first thing Trump tried to ban is Muslim, and I have called this out on several of my recordings that you weren't about. All these other people you're seeing that the Muslim and are causing problems. The Muslims are gonna attack America. It's not the Muslims that are attacking America. People, Caucasian men are attacking America. Let me see if they have the names. I want to read out the names of these white supremacists, these white, not supremacists, I don't even say that, I don't know why I say that, that's what, because I'm looking at this, white nationalists that are domestic terrorists. I can say Donald Trump is a domestic terrorist because he called out of killing people that was innocent. They found, like I said, Central Five, he called them out and it wasn't true. He not only he's a racist, he's a domestic terrorist. When it comes down to, he will go against everybody in America except Putin and Russia. He have no desire. He cares nothing about America. Just a domestic terrorist again. A white Caucasian, a pale faced Caucasian. We had this name is not calling. We had Dylan Roof that did it. Tim McVeigh. We had all these people that were as Caucasian men that actually that caused problems. Hold on. That actually did domestic terrorists, but the first thing they want to put on there that it's Muslims. Why? Because they are people of color. That's what it boils down to. You guys are the most racist piece of shit that I ever known. Anybody out there, you're racist, and I know you don't care, and I care less about you as well. So we're even. Not gonna. I keep on telling you, I'm not my ancestors. I'm not gonna kumbaya with you, not at all. Oh, let's go here. I am looking this up. on my other computer because it is taking too long on the other one. So bear with me. Okay, let's see. We're going to have Islam domestic. I don't want the relationship. I did it the wrong way. I put it. Yep, I have to look this up because this is my computer. Oh, it's finally come up. Okay. Yeah, we have one of Dell and Ruth they have here in what the heck. And we have other people up here. Tim McVeigh they have up here. Yep. Tim McVeigh. Dell and Ruth. Stop jumping. My computer is jumping. I don't know what's wrong with it right now. And they have the Ku Klux Klans, the Nationalists. We have all these people that's domestic terrorists. See, they don't want, they want you to hate Muslims so much, but it's all domestic terrorists. It's worse than, because it's within. They're killing people, period. They're killing people because of skin color. They're toggling people. They, if someone of African descent or anything of dark skin, if someone who have a pale face standing next to them, they don't care. They'll kill them too. As long as they get that person with dark skin, they have no, they can care less. That's how it is. They can care less. They don't care. Not at all. So, trying to get the young, the older guy name up, and somehow this is computer continue to like. I want to play the video as well. Of them, you heard some of it, but I want to play the whole video. If this work, it will work. If it doesn't, then oh well, can't do anything about. What's going on with my computer right now? I'm trying to bring up my other computer so I can go in here and so you guys can hear the recording that he actually just went in there and stabbed this old guy and killed him. And he saw his name and his face on the media, news media, and he decided to turn himself in. And he walked in. They had the picture of him walking in with the sword in his hand. They did not pull out a gun and killed him. That's why I try to tell them. People, that's why it kills me when I hear Caucasians up there say, just do what the officer says. 9 out of 10, we do. They still shoot us because of the color of our skin. We can twitch and they'll shoot us. But a Caucasian can have a gun in their hand, like when the guy stood off in Colorado in the government building. You're never supposed to have a gun in the government building. And they stayed there for months and they didn't do anything. Why? Because you have that white privilege. You have those white privileges. And you sit up there and thinking that we're not abiding by the law. We are abiding by the law. You guys just don't know and don't care. The first thing you say, you're not abiding by the law. And we are. It's just the fact that they are shooting us down. It's because we are people of color. You guys can do whatever you want to do. And it is okay. it is okay. And you don't have to worry about getting shot down. Like I said, this man walked in there with a sword. What, he killed someone? And they just handcuffed him. Simple as that. They didn't do nothing else but handcuffed him. And don't sit up there and tell me, oh, he served in the United States Army. Guess what? It's a lot of African Americans who got killed. Matter of fact, it was a African American the other day that got killed and was killed in prison. Let's see if y'all can hear this.
Want to give an update to the story?
Nope, I don't want that. African American who was in the cell, he said he was paralyzed. And all the guards let him lay on the ground because his neck was, I don't know if it says back or neck was broken. And they let him lay on the ground and he died with, he was in his own urine and feces. So when you tell me that it's just an insult, you wonder why most of us get pissed off when you say some crap like that. You should have just listened to what the officer said. Well, we do. We do. They just don't want to, they really don't care. Simple as that. They really don't care. They have nothing to say. They still. It just kills me. I had to breathe on that because it pissed me the hell off. I'm trying to get this up so we can listen to the interview that they have. Ugh, it just takes me off. Oh, there go ahead. Let's see if this can go up. See if it come on. Again, a white nationalist. Here we go. Trying to get this interview. It's hard to get this interview come up, really. Let's see, I do it this way. I really want you guys to hear this. Up and it's funny how people will say fake news real quick. You already know who I'm talking about. It's not coming up. That's the only thing that I hate because I want you guys to hear. Let's see if I can do it this way. Because it just ticks me off when Trump sit up there and says, we don't have domestic violence, we have terrorism. We have it from Muslims, we have it from this and we have it from that. But we have domestic terrorism all day long. All day long. And it's not the people of color. It's the people, it's people within. It's people here. It's Caucasians who's doing these things. It's the Caucasians. who's killing and getting away with it. But the first thing they look at it and they say, y'all the one violent. You guys are violent. We are not violent. You guys are violent. Interesting. It's amazing. And they're not broadcasting this at all. But if it was a black man, they'll be broadcasting this all day. And they're not talking about James Jackson at all. They're not talking about this racist. They're trying to keep it hush-hush. You're not going to keep nothing hush-hush. Because as long as I am recording, I'm going to record this and let you guys hear that this Caucasian went out and killed a 66-year-old African-American man, still alive, walked into the police station and had his sword in his hand, and he is still alive. And everybody know, if that was a black man that walked in there, they would have killed him. Simple as that. A 28-year-old white man walked in and confessed he killed a man because of he was black. You can hear the playing. They're just putting, they want you to read this. I'm trying to get to the interview. I want you guys to hear the interview, what they were saying. I tried it on YouTube, couldn't get that because it was somebody else recording it and everything, and I don't want to hear somebody else's voice on my show, only if I'm interviewing them. So let me see, that didn't play off, it just, anyway, look it up. His name is James Harris Jackson. He killed a 66-year-old man, and they're really trying to keep this hush-hush. They did an interview. I saw the interview yesterday, but they're not showing it, and I'm not going to waste my time on this anymore. You can also look up the African-American man who was, who died in his feces. They ignored when he said that he was paralyzed, and they ignored that. So you make a comparison. Who lives matters. That's why black lives matter out now. You sit up here and say, oh, you guys always saying black lives matters and well, guess what? It really does. And they will sit up there and say, we don't need Black Lives Matter, but we do. Because you guys are still killing. Not all Caucasian, but majority of you are killing us left and right. Because of your threat. You want to be like us. And it's good that Get Out is out. That movie Get Out is out. Because it really portrayed that you want to be us, but you don't want to be us. Because you know what you're doing. So this is crazy. They said a 15-year-old reportedly gang raped on Facebook Live. What the fuck? And nobody didn't call the police. What is going on? Mm-hmm. Look at this O'Reilly.
Attacked by a gang, all right? We don't know if they're an organized gang or just a group on Facebook. Okay, on Facebook
Live. Okay, yeah.
Right. Here's
this
the moment.
This is Bill O'Reilly. I don't listen to Fox News. I just was looking at that, and I don't know if it's true or fact, because he now talking about fake news. Now that is fake news. But anyway, I'm just rambling, and I just want to get into those things. Y'all need to correct y'all president. Y'all voted for. He's trying to hurt you dearly. He's going to hurt you dearly. Yes, he is. Love you guys. Muchies! But before I go, I want you guys to think about this. What makes you so different from me? What makes you so different because of your skin color? Oh, excuse me. What make you so different from anybody skin color. I mean, you're not different. You're not better than I am. But somehow you think you are because you was raised in an environment that tells you that you're better than me. Is this love that you portray for your brother and sister because my skin color is dark? Is that love? How is that love? It's not love. You hate me because of my skin color. You hate me because I look different than you. You hate me because of my lips, my nose. But somehow you go to a doctor and try to get the lips and the nose and the buttocks. But you hate me so much. Have a good day.